Chicago, 1932. Behind the crash of 29, the dollar goes into decline. The land of freedom overnight becomes a land of dispossessed. They used to go to ball games, they used to drive their cars, they used to watch the movies, they used to drink in bars. Now shanty towns are rising and money ceases to flow, so now they stay at home and listen to the radio.
But that's not what our show's about tonight.
What?
It's called The Big Broadcast.
Yeah, but it's about us.
And you are?
Oh, we'll get to that.
But it's set in a radio station.
Yes, but we're the story.
This is a show about radio.
No, it's a show about writing a song.
Actually, the story is about me.
And who are you?
Don't you know him?
Never met him before. Are you on the radio?
I am now.
This is getting us nowhere.
No, no, no. Hey!
Bowling's are so damn hard. There's so much stuff to get across, so punters won't be at a loss. Who are these people, where do they live, and what do they want? Openings are so damn hard.
To tell them all you can afford, but not too much or they'll get bored.
Just introducing all the parts before the story even starts. There is a bucket full of need-to-know stuff, which is why openings are so damn tough.
Okay, here's what I guess you need to know. The year is 1932, 3 years into the Great Depression. Thank you, Wall Street. The place is Chicago, Illinois, and my name is Jean Forsyth. Actress, songwriter, primarily lyrics, trendsetter, and radio star.
And don't forget wife.
How could I forget wife?
How indeed?
Your wife.
And I am.
Grant Thornhill.
The very same. Actor, songwriter, primarily music, bon viveur, radio star.
And gambler.
Occasionally.
Constantly.
Sporadically.
And my husband.
Indeed.
But not for much longer.
Oh, now you've gone and spoiled it.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
There you were, delivering a nice, straightforward introduction to the piece. Everybody knew where they were, then bam!
How awful of me.
They're just getting used to the idea of us as a starry couple of songwriters.
George and Irene Gershwin.
And suddenly...
bam!
You tell them we're getting a divorce?
Well, we are.
Just one tiny detail you appear to have overlooked.
Which is?
You hadn't told me.
Well, I have now.
Mind telling me why?
Three little words.
I love you.
$5,000.
As in,
where's the $5,000 you withdrew from our account?
My response? Four little words.
I'll phone my lawyer.
I'll get it back.
Take this current situation. There is more than meets the eye.
She's the one we're supposed to root for, but I'd like to hear his side.
And who are these people anyway? I don't recognize their names.
Well, they're Cary Grant and Hepburn, but they don't cost quite the same.
And it's all set in Chicago, where the dollar's on the floor.
Not much different to today, except our banks charge even more.
And it's a musical with drama.
Or perhaps a play with song.
And we're doing it on the radio. What the hell is going on?
Openings are so damn hard. To marshal just the facts we need to get the listener up to speed. 2 minutes to learn the score, then they'll listen for 40 more. Openings are so damn hard.
Not just with his cash, but with mine.
In fact, we write a catchy song, won't guarantee we'll get along.
And it's endings, not openings that we hate. That's a play of art. So lay it on, to quote the bard. But why are openings just so damn hard?
And so, Grant is out of the door.
I did have a suitcase. Thank you.
And I am left in our mortgaged house with no money, no husband, and no prospects. Just me, this bottle of bootleg whiskey, and the radio.
What's the top?
On the lakes of Minnesota.
Alaskan plain. Over the hills of North and South Dakota comes the hour of charm once again.
You are listening to radio station WKAZ, broadcasting to you live from the Belvedere Theater in downtown Chicago, and your very own Chicago Beefsteak Hour of Charm. Now we return to our gripping story of love and heartache as Martha searches for Billy amongst the crashing waves of Shipwreck Point.
Go music. Go wind machine. Go sea effect.
What are you doing way out here at Shipwreck Point? Go back!
Oh, Billy, why did you run away?
I can't hear you over these terrible winds!
What?
I said I can't hear you over these terrible winds!
Oh, hold me, Billy.
Martha, I lied to you.
I'm sure it wasn't a big lie.
The biggest lie. When I saw your humble but welcoming tenement building with your poor but resilient parents, your eight brothers and sisters whom you cared for like a mother...
They all love you too, Billy.
And you told me that you hated money, that money wouldn't bring happiness, only misery and bitterness. I couldn't tell you the truth about myself.
The truth?
I'm a millionaire. My father owns Piers and Joe Buck, the biggest store in Chicago.
Oh, Billy!
But I know you won't want me now. I've lied to you. I've lied to you and I'm rich. And I'll just grow up solitary and bitter and miserable.
You're wrong, Billy Clitheroe.
Go music.
Oh, Billy, with your wealth, we can build schools, hospitals, new homes for the poorest in our community so that having no money doesn't mean losing one's dignity.
You mean?
Yes, Billy. I'm not leaving you at Shipwreck Point. I'm rescuing you so that together we can rescue others.
Oh, Martha!
Oh, Billy!
Oh, brother.
That was Shipwreck Point, the Hour of Charm serial. Tune in next week when Billy and Martha make their wedding plans but fall foul of gangsters. Well, friends, you know that the best thing to give your family on these cold nights is Chicago beefsteak. Created from four of the best cuts of lean Montana beef, mixed with Oklahoma grain and six essential spices of the mysterious East. And boy, do they taste good.
It's tasty, it's healthy, it's fresh off the farm. It's chock full of goodness, for goodness sake. It brings you your favorite hour of charm. It's the one, the only Chicago Beefsteak.
And that's all from this week's Chicago Beefsteak Hour of Charm. But tune in again next week when our guests will be that popular duo of the airwaves, Grant Thornhill and Gene Forsyth, with an all-new song they've written especially for this program.
Bye, 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 bye.
And we are out. Thank you, everybody.
Yes, wonderful show, everybody. Very good. Thank you.
237 editions of the Hour of Charm. And that one has got to be the most stomach-turning.
Haven't you got some studio managing to do?
I can't remember the last time we had a riveting show. Oh, yeah, back in 31, when that actor had a fit of nerves and couldn't speak. He had to murmur every line into his ear, and he just repeated them. When the scene finished, he collapsed. He never worked again.
That's because you sent him on saying, "Don't worry, there's only a million people listening."
Do you ever wonder, Arthur?
Wonder what?
Well, night after night, there you are in your tux selling meat. What does it all mean, Arthur?
What does what all mean?
Life. This. The Hour of Charm.
It means we don't have to starve.
You ever eaten a Chicago beefsteak?
No.
It tastes like shoe leather fried in aviation fuel.
And all the time I don't eat one, I can sell them with conviction. This is radio. It's an illusion. And people in these times need an awful lot of illusion.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.